Hey guys, today I'm working on this brand new 2016 Toyota Tacoma, and the customer wanted just a little bit better of a sound system. It's the TRD package, but it doesn't have the premium audio system with the factory subwoofer. So what we're going to do is we're going to build the most compact system that we possibly can within the budget. We don't have a huge budget because we want to put a ton of money into it, but I'm going to show you guys a system where you really don't have to spend a lot of money to get good audio quality, because that's the goal here. So this is the system that we're putting in today. The vehicle already has a screen in it, so we don't really need to mess with that. Now, if you were looking for more features like screen mirroring, or you wanted to have more control over the audio system, I would definitely recommend upgrading this. There are parts available, and this deck is pretty easy to take out of this truck. But the customer really likes this, and he has a factory backup camera, so we're gonna maintain it, no problem. In order to keep this in line, we're gonna use the audio control LC79. I really like this piece because it's very simple to install, very compact, it's very low, it's gonna fit where we need it to. And it's not as expensive as a digital sound processor, but it's not as low featured as a line output converter, because with a line output converter, yes, you can adjust the gains, but that's about it. The LC7i is kind of like a hybrid. The reason why I like this is because we can put in a lot of wattage through it, it can handle it, but it has what it's called, it has AccuBass. And what AccuBass is, it compensates for bass roll-off. What a lot of you might not know is, on newer cars, when you turn up the volume, I don't know if you've noticed this, put your volume to half. It sounds really bassy for a stock system. Keep turning up the volume. Yes, your volume gets louder, but the bass goes away. Manufacturers do that on purpose because they engineer the speakers well for fitment, but they don't use the highest quality speakers, and they can't handle a lot of bass. So they do bass roll-off. So as you pull up the volume, it will reduce the bass, saving the speakers. What this will do is, for our subwoofer, as we turn up the volume, bass roll-off may occur on our speakers, which is fine, but the subs will continue to put out bass as the volume goes up, which is what we want. For the amplifier, again, I'm doing Kenwood's XR series. This is their 905 5-channel. I love doing 5-channels, it's my thing. And I'm doing the Exelon because it's just very small, and it's pretty much the only amp that's gonna fit under the seat, given my constraints. For subs, I decided to try something different. I made a sealed enclosure and I'm running Hertz 6.5-inch speakers in it on their woofers. So this isn't a coaxial speaker. Like, it's pretty much, we're using a speaker in a subwoofer. The mechanics are actually identical. It's just that the frequencies are different. So what we're trying to do here is use the exact same mechanics as we would in a subwoofer and use it for this application. Obviously, we're gonna tune the frequencies out so this thing doesn't distort, but we wanted to try something like this because a lot of factory systems like Bose kind of do things like this, so we're gonna try to mimic what they do. Whenever I have a heads up, like usually when I do systems like this, I book them a week out and I do my smaller jobs in the meantime because that gives me time to order parts, because what I've done is I've ordered the factory style plugs to plug back into the factory deck, and then we have the other end that plugs into the original plug. This way, we don't cut up any of the wiring in the truck. I can do most of the work on the bench, which is what I prefer to do. I don't like to solder in the vehicle because it's cramped, and it just looks nice. And then I'm just showing you this, you can see everything soldered and shrink tube. I'm actually gonna test the tape up to here and cover everything just to make it look a little bit more clean, then you don't see all these wires. And for the wiring, I am using Stinger Elites, or Stinger's True Copper Wiring. It's their Elite Series. And their RCAs. First stage of the install is done. We are running signal. Now you can see why I like to do everything on the bench, because I just plug everything in. So here's the factory plugs. I'm plugged into that, so that will hook up to our amplifier. And we have power and everything going to the original style plugs off of here. So all we have to do is just plug in the factory head unit and we're done. And if for some reason you want to take this out, just unplug it. Nothing's butchered and it looks good. See, aren't you guys happy there are people like me that actually care about stuff like this and make your factory wiring look good behind it, even though you never see it? Got my underhood all done. I've mounted the fuse holder nicely here. On this particular truck, there's nothing for the hinge system for the hood to come down on some trucks too, so this is totally clear. This is a good spot to have it. Easy to service, looks good here. You can see there I've run with all the factory lines. If I were to put the amp on the driver's seat, I would go straight in through that grommet, but because I'm going on the passenger seat, I've run with the factory line back to the grommet here. There's another grommet you can see right there on the firewall. That's a great place to go through. And because we know the engineer has designed the wiring to go, there's factory wiring up there, we know heat's not gonna be an issue or anything. I wanna mention I did a video on this earlier at the end of last year about Toyota batteries not being the best quality. Again, it doesn't look like they've really upped that. I would highly, even though it's the brand new truck with this sound system, and so our wiring doesn't get corroded over time, I would definitely change this out to something better. We're wiring up the amplifier now. When you are working with your speaker lines on amplifiers like this, where it is set screws that clamp onto the wire, so literally the screw just keeps going down into the built-in threads of the amplifier, and then it crushes the wire. What I like to do is, if you're not using those ferrule connectors, except for the power lines, I would do that for sure, is I tin the tip, memorize, just the tip of the wire. That way, when the screws into it, it's less likely to break, because on some of these wires, they're very thin now, or you might be dealing, this is 100% copper, but if you're dealing, especially if you're dealing with copper clad aluminum, you are more prone to breakage, and you might not notice that it's broken, but then you're actually losing the thickness of the wire because it's broken a couple times. So by tinning the tip a little bit, it makes it a lot more durable. I have the audio control piece open now, and here's the cool thing about it. It's also a summing device. And what I mean by summing device is, when you're integrating with a factory head unit, you have to deal with things where sometimes a vehicle like Dodge Rams, for example, the Alpine sound system, the dash speakers and the door speakers actually are crossed over, so you don't have full range. Well, something like this does is, what you could do is, here you'd have the dash speakers, and then here you'd have the door speakers, and you can sum these two together. You'll lose fade because you'd also do this to the rear, and then you'd have full range going to your amplifier. And then on this output here, you can hook up to the factory subwoofer. This will allow you to get full range and get all the frequencies you want out of your aftermarket sound system. Now, in this particular case, I don't have to deal with that because I have I don't have an amplified sound system, but what I have to deal with is I'm only doing fronts and rears. So this section here would be for the subwoofer. I don't have anything to put into it. Now, you could just jump this over. I wouldn't do that, because what this has the ability to do is we can sum the signal together. So I am actually combining the rears with the output of the subwoofer. What this is going to do is, I'm going to have full range going to the amplifier for the subwoofer output, and then I'll just do all my tuning at the amplifier. So we're going to turn our low pass filter, and then we're only going to play certain frequencies and below. The audio control also has some other cool features, where it has signal sensing. So if you had retain accessory power, and when you were to remove the keys, the head unit stays on. As long as music keeps playing, it will stay on. Or we can set it up so it has switch ignition or switch accessory, so when the line powers down, this just shuts off right away. There also are other features that where we can change the way that it's grounded through the system, in case you have things like engine noise, that you can change some settings to eliminate that engine noise. It's really rare you get that in a proper install, but in some vehicles you do, but this gives you the ability to try eliminate that as well. Here's the wiring for the 5-channel and the audio control LC79 all done. I ground it right here. I also use dielectric grease as a paste to help make sure there's no corrosion, and then I also spray it. So here's the dielectric grease that I use with anti-corrosion gel. And then I also spray it on top with this. Now this is a rocker guard. This is actually their temporary version, and it's not actually like paint. This actually can come off. So when you're painting the interior, one, it's clear, so if there's any overspray, you don't see it. Two, we're not actually putting a permanent type of material down. And I find that's better for use for interior use. And you see everything's nice and clean. Tesla taped. The reason why the audio control piece is here and the amp is here, because usually you want the amplifier in the back of the seat, that way it's easy to tune because all the settings are here, is because the audio control piece is a lot shorter and there's this bar, and I didn't want to cut this, and there's much more clearance back here on the seat. You can see there's a lot of stuff going on. So for height restrictions, I had to put the amplifier back here, and I've been spending a lot of time tuning it with this loose, that way I can get at everything. So you know how I like to set my amplifiers where it's very easy to tune, very serviceable? Unfortunately, I couldn't do it in this case because of all the restrictions I have. But what the user gets in the end of the day is a very usable truck, because they're not going to feel their seat hitting anything as they move it back and forth. Our system's all done. I always put the boxes and my paperwork all on the passenger seat so the customer knows what I've done for them. We have full operation of the seat. You can see a little bit of the wiring, but it's out of the way. But this seat moves back and forth, doesn't get hung up, so no one really knows that's there. The back, Oh, I also, I don't know if I mentioned this, the speakers I left alone, they are stock. We just gave them more power to get more control and better sound quality from them. For the back, it's our little mini sub enclosure. Now what this sounds like is, it basically sounds like the stock system, but clearer. These little 6.5 inch, this particular setup does not have a lot of low end grunt, but it fills the system quite nicely. So it just sounds more full, but it doesn't, you can't feel it in your chest, that's for sure. Just, you know, there's no replacement for displacement. If you want big boomy sound that you can feel, you have to step up to quite a substantial 8. You can do probably small 8 and then fill up this whole bottom section. The reason why we went with this enclosure is because the stealth enclosure from JL Audio does not fit. It fits on the sides just fine, it'll drop in, but this part comes out so much that the seat can't go back in place. And the customer wanted to save some money and they didn't want to go custom, so they didn't, well, they didn't want to go like full on custom, and they wanted to do a more economical setup. So we scaled it down because all they were looking for really was just a nice full sound, and they didn't want any boominess to it at all. So this fit the bill. But if you are someone that's looking for something that you can feel in your chest, this is not the way to go. I'll admit that. I'll be the first one to admit that. But if you're looking, if you've never had subs before and you want to know what it's all about, this is a good place to start. But because the amplifier that we picked with that XR905, if I ever wanted to change up the subs, go with something a little bit bigger and actually build something, if they want to spend some more money and build something bigger back here, no problem, we have the power for it. Hopefully you guys learned something new about how to maintain your factory head unit and increase sound quality by just adding a simple 5-channel amplifier. You'll save a lot of money because you didn't have to change out the speakers, but you have the power now later down the road. When it's time to get more sound quality, you can. Also, hopefully you've seen that there are other possibilities to doing sub enclosures when you're dealing with a vehicle like this where you have very limited space and you just want to get more sound, or get a more full sound out of your sound system. Make sure to check out all my other social media, AnthonyJ350 on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, and check out my website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.